For thousands of parents, undoubtedly in the tri-state last night, it was concern throughout most of the evening until they found out that their youngsters did make it home safely from that concert by The Who at Riverfront Coliseum. The ending, however, was not as fortunate for a number of them.
Thousands of young people had gathered hours early to get into Riverfront Coliseum in Cincinnati, Ohio. The attraction was the British rock band, The Who. Suddenly, one pair of doors to the Coliseum was broken open, and the waiting throng rushed inside, eager to get the best possible seats.
A crowd of 5,000 to 6,000 people tried to squeeze through three doors. 11 people were crushed. We have a partial list of the dead. One name is still being withheld at this hour. Karen Morrison, aged 15, Cincinnati. 15-year-old Jacqueline Eckerly of Cincinnati. 18-year-old Peter Bowes of Wyoming. Connie Burns of Miamisburg, Ohio. 17-year-old Brian Wagner of Fort Thomas, Kentucky. Tiva Ladd from Newtown. David Heck of Highland Heights, Kentucky. James Warmoth of Franklin. Walter Adams Jr. of Dayton, Ohio. And 19-year-old Steve Preston of Finneytown. But for those who survived the crush, it was a nightmare they won't forget for a long time. City officials are promising to find answers for questions like, why did this happen? And how can it be prevented next time?
No one knows why. This morning, city officials plan to begin an investigation into what happened. And officials admitted that the general admission seating arrangements for about half the audience was a factor in the tragedy. They concede that if everyone had assigned seats, there probably would have been no reason for the deadly stampede. The tragedy outside the Coliseum did not stop the concert. Many of the people inside with reserved seats said they were not aware that anyone was killed at the entrance.
And the whole band is shattered. We just feel helpless at the moment. We finished our act and we came off and we were asked to do a short encore because they had problems. And by the look on my manager's face, I knew something was serious had happened. We did a very short encore and we came off and he told us. I mean, we didn't know prior to the show at all.
For 36 years, the Finneytown community has tried to push past the pain of one tragic night when three of their own were killed at the Who concert.
I think it's important, number one, that we always remember their laugh, their candor, how fun they always were to hang out with.
Friends have worked hard to make sure Stephen Preston, Karen Morrison, and Jackie Eckerly will never be forgotten.
Rather than allowing that to be the final chapter of their lives here on Earth, what we're doing is we're providing 3 scholarships each year in the name of our friends to Finneytown seniors that are pursuing a secondary education in the arts. It could be a minor or major.
We stay in touch with the families.
You do?
They have a memorial fund where they provide scholarships at one of the high schools. This high school lost 3 students, so they provide 3 scholarships every year. Wonderful people. It's so hard for us, but it's not as hard for us as it was for them. I visited them. I went back and visited the high school in the summer.
They were all so young.
15.
Oh. Yes. Well, you were in the doorway?
Yeah.
Well, you know, one of the things, I don't know whether any of you understand, but you know, they, the police and the fire, if you wanted to get the crowd back out. They wanted us to not to play.
Yeah.
And it was our manager who said, if you do that, you'll have a bigger problem.
Oh,
and he really has never been thanked for what he did that night, because he had huge rounds with them. Which would have made their rescue job so much harder.
That's Bill Kirby's show.
Yeah.
It was.
It was really strange to have, from our position, you know, everyone's looking for someone to blame.
Yeah, right.
And,
and you know what? One thing I got to tell
you. Well, thank you. It means a lot to me.
I can tell you that. We never did.
Because there's always a certain amount of, if I hadn't been doing this,
no.
It would have happened, you know. You can't, that's just human nature, that's what we carry.
The whole thing, exactly.
Yeah, but Bill Kirby really deserves a huge thank you for what he did that night.
Thank you.
Because he protected so many others.
Well, this whole thing has been such a healing thing for all of us. And that's such a cathartic thing you guys have
all. Well, you know, one day I hope he will come.
Yeah.
And I hope if one day we will come together. I think Pete took it very, very hard.
Sure.
You know, he's got this kind of tough exterior. He's not at all. No, he's not at all. And he took it extremely hard. We both did.
Thank you.